How about those apples?
How about those apples? How about them apples? How about them apples?
Oh, good. My Amazon delivery's coming in.
Oh, well, autocorrect on that.
Hey, hi.
Welcome to day four of training on how to pray in every situation. And we're talking about the Lord's Prayer today. So in Luke chapter 11, so it goes, the New Testament goes Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Luke is the one that we're talking about. It says, one day Jesus was praying in a certain place, and when he finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray. And I'm sure they saw Jesus praying all the time, and maybe that's you. Maybe you see people praying or you hear about it and you're like, gosh, it must be nice. I wish I knew how to do that. That was me for a long time. That's why I'm going through this. I just want to take you along with us, and I want you to be able to learn how to pray. So we're going to go through the Lord's Prayer, and this is part one. We're going to break this thing down, and I'm going to teach you part by part exactly how to pray the Lord's Prayer, okay? So in Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 through 13 is where we see the Lord's Prayer. And this is Jesus speaking, and he says, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forget our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Now, the very first part of this scripture is about connecting with God relationally. See, God doesn't just want you to follow all these rules. He wants to have a relationship with you. And maybe that's different for you. Maybe you've never really thought about it, but I don't have any relationships that are based entirely off of rules. Like if I get pulled over by a police officer, that's not a relationship. I just broke the rule. God doesn't want just some rules for you. He wants a relationship, and a relationship is dialogue back and forth, and it's knowing who you are and knowing who He is. God isn't interested in us practicing a religion. You gotta get that. That's huge. God doesn't want you to practice being religious. He wants you to connect with Him. At some point, it's gonna get so good when you pray that it's just gonna be you looking forward to spending time with God. That's what He wants. He wants to be close. See, the Bible actually says that God has adopted us as kids, and He loves it when we call Him Father. Romans chapter 8, verse 15 says, You have not received a spirit that makes you fearful slaves. Instead, you received God's Spirit when He adopted you as His own children. And now we call Him Abba, Father. It just simply means that God wants us to call Him Father. That's what the beginning of the Lord's Prayer is all about. It is about us connecting with Him as a father, where you would just run to your dad and you want to tell him about your day, where you love him and you recognize, hey, listen, I'm just one of your kids. I want to be close with you, and I know that you want to be close with me. So your challenge today is that you would just take a minute and connect with God as a father, but you would also thank Him for making you one of His children, that He adopted you into His family. Take a minute and just talk to God about that. Father, I come to you in prayer today, and I'm thankful that I'm your child. And I know that I'm a sinner, but you've forgiven me and you have adopted me as your own. And so I'm grateful to call you my Father. Thank you for loving me. I love you. In Jesus' name, amen. Come back tomorrow. We're going to continue going through the Lord's Prayer. This is what training looks like. It's just us getting down, breaking it down piece by piece, and learning how to pray so you can do it. We'll see you tomorrow.